Okay, hey, hello everybody. Today I will be streaming Death Stranding for a couple of hours. I wanted to play Apex Legends since yesterday was the European and Middle East tournament. But I decided to play Death Stranding a little bit more. Okay, to the evil biologist. Oh, the pun is not intended that I'm listening to the JRE experience and we have some geologist, Egyptologist in his podcast. But yeah. Okay.
Hello?
Do I have some hot springs here? Nothing.
Do you say?
Thanks to the chiral contamination, all clears up. Nasty symptoms though, dizziness, headaches, insomnia. Of course, I was worried it was all down to my isolation in the shelter and the intense focus on my research. But I got really bad when the nightmare started. I saw the end of the road, a portal to the beach opening, and beaches pouring through by the thousands. There was nowhere to run, no time, and they began scooping us up one by one. And then the void arms came bigger and bigger until a massive one of several massive ones enveloped the whole world. Poof, just like that. And I told Hartman about it, he likened it to the visions of extinction, dooms, suffers them to experience. It's strange though, after all, we now have in control of the world proof that incontrovertible proof that Kyrellium is far from a recent addition to our world. Anyway, but a problem for different days. The important thing is that I'm cured and it's all thanks to you. You're welcome. Oh,
anybody home?
I saw something here. Keep on keeping on.
Weapons restrictions lifted.
Hello.
Had the texture and feel of some of the explosives they would use. We would use these when we collected fossils. explain that.
Yeah, I had to explain all that. And, someone came from the Pakistan Geological Survey and explained that, I really was who I was. But, it's a situation where people get excited, and that was back in the bad old days. So, I don't know if it's any better in Pakistan now, but, they're tough situations, but if you know how to behave and you know how to deal with it, you know how to avoid it, you'll be okay. And right now, I can say Egypt is very... people have all kinds of misconceptions about Egypt. Turkey, we were starting to talk about Turkey. Turkey may be going down the route a little bit, being very honest. But I have no problem going with Turkey. I have no problem taking people to Turkey. But at this point, there are certain areas I'd like to avoid, just to be...
Thank you.
Don't mind me.
Don't mind me. Don't mind me.
I'll let you know if I need anything else.
Hey there!
Hey there!
Thank you for everything.
Let's go! On keeping on.
Okay.
Them all.
Started with, there's a lot of things happening. No, it did not. It started with.
That's it.
Whew. There we go. There we go.
Thank you. impressed, Sam. Not many people would have even attempted this. May I have a look? Not a scratch on it. You do not disappoint, my friend. And so then Joe had told Bob Cook, who's my manager, big time manager since the beginning of my career, hey, Bob and I are
thank you. It goes without saying, but I am convinced that the TAR is related to the BTs, and that, after all, both it and Timefall are the defining features of the post-strand. Sudden environmental changes, such as these, invariably lead to the extinction of organisms that fail to adapt. Those that do adapt do so by virtue of enhancers, the regions of DNA that grant successful organisms. These genetic factors are the key to evolution. But there are genes which have the opposite effect, those which disadvantage organisms, extinction factors, as they have been called. These are the seeds of advancement and obsolescence. Such factors may lie dormant within us all, a choice waiting to be made for every being since the advent of life itself. If so, then ancient proof may hide deep within the TAR, evidence of these genetic decisions that may aid us in navigating our current crossroads. In any event, thanks to you, I can now study the composition of the TAR in greater detail. I'll make sure to share any interesting results.
Well done, Sam. You furthered our research into the Death Stranding in ways you cannot imagine. Thank you again for bringing me Mama's body, as well as that ammonite. Speaking of which, my analysis of its umbilical cord is proceeding apace. I've been comparing the data against some of our restored archives. Anyway, would you mind returning to my lab? Preparations are finally complete for the chiral relay integration. If you could collect the necessary materials for the restoration work and bring them here, I would be most grateful.
Good work. New order available. Please access delivery terminal.
Joe, and you don't have all these negative shit. As a matter
support.
Keep on keeping on. Keep on keeping on.
Weapons restrictions lifted.
There we go.
Thank you. Thank you. doing this?
Thank you.
Let's get the zone up.
Scanning bridges ID. Verifying
ID. Yeah, sure thing.
Clear. Weapons detected. All weapons will be locked until departure. Cargo verified. Thank you. Deploying off.
Thank you.
gas ejections from the sun somewhere around 10,000 years ago that basically killed off a giant percentage of the population. Lightning storms millions of times greater than anything we've ever experienced before. That literally, which like lightning coming down like rain, barbecuing the ground, killing people, people forced into caves, civilization resets. It's almost like we need something like that. What can we be upset about? Because now, instead of being upset about Roseanne or Samantha B or Samantha B, who's the C-word today, that naughty guy.
I say everyone should just wait like 48 hours and everybody hates you, and then you know it's the next person that they have to hate.
Yeah, well, that's one of the cool things about the internet is that the cycle, boy, it hits you hard, but then it goes back pretty quick.
Really fast.
Yeah.
It's nice and never that serious.
It's not like the old days when someone got in trouble with something, boy, that trouble stuck.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You know?
I don't know that time. I genuinely don't know that time. I'm old. 29. I just turned 29.
Yeah, so you're very, very young in the shit stirring culture.
Yeah.
Yeah,
exactly.
This is all new stuff to you.
You too, yeah. And I think the thing that sucks for me is that I'm really conscious of it. Like, I wish I thought all of these people would be here. But, like, you know, like, you mentioned this before this. I'm like, oh, let me do Instagram stories. I'm about to go into a room with like, hey, guys. And they're doing it. And they're like, oh, yeah, like, holding my phone. And they're like, talking to this device.
At least you're aware of it. So that's
odd.
It kind
of sucks that I'm aware of it. Like, it would be so much more natural if I wasn't aware of it. You know, the girl that just, hey, guys, yeah, all day. And it feels normal. So being conscious of it is kind of not that fun.
That's probably the best way to approach it, though, to be conscious about goofiness, because if you're just swept away in the zeitgeist...
I don't know. I think it's better. Yeah, ignorance is really bliss. I think there are people that think it's the most normal thing in the world to just put your entire life on social media, and I actually don't think it's the most normal thing in the world, but my entire life is on social media.
Well, I've just met you, but you seem like a very bright woman, and that's probably part of the problem.
Yeah.
Because you're not stupid. If you're stupid, you'd be, like, putting everything on Instagram, and you'd be... You'd do the selfie face. This is my favorite part of this thing.
I know. I'm really bad at selfies. My cousin always has to take them before the same picture. But I'm getting good at my like Instagram angle and like, the things that I say. Like, I'll keep that, like,
thank you for your contribution.
He saw you on Fox News. He's like, who's this girl? She's making so much sense. He's like super hardcore conservative.
Yeah.
So he likes when anyone who's like young and conservative. He like loves Ben Shapiro. He loves all that shit.
Yeah.
So he got excited about you.
Yeah, people get really excited. I think it's just because I'm really unapologetically myself. And today that's like, it's like seeing an alien.
Well, it's hard to pull off, right? Because people get mad at you. People are trying to, this one thing that is absolutely happening, whether people like it or not, or believe it or not, is that people are trying to silence other people's opinions.
That's right.
If you say something that doesn't
here. I'm Sam!
ID. Verifying ID. Clear. Weapons detected. All weapons will be locked until departure. All clear. Welcome, Sam.
Like, they're pretty, things are happening in my life that don't make sense when they happen. You're like, oh my god, me. And then, like, get a little older and you're like, this makes my face. it was like my life wasn't mine. Like I went from like sitting down watching, I was watching Talladega Nights with my boyfriend to being the most discussed person in the state of Connecticut. And what was interesting about it was just that because it was the governor of Connecticut's son that was in this car, they had to get the FBI involved to determine the authenticity of what maybe she called herself. Right? Instead of just saying like yes, it was my son, he actually let the FBI investigate for 6 weeks and waited for his son to get arrested 6 weeks. Like, you know what I mean? Like,
did his son deny it?
Retrospect, I understand.
Hear me?
See you safe. Good. Be sure to call on you again.
Good work. New order available. Please access.
Same place where a couple years ago? No, that wasn't.
come.
I know.
Weapons restrictions. Keep on keeping on.
Okay.
Thank you.
Gotta wake up, Lou.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Messages, find their messages,
yeah,
find
the archive.
Good work. New order available. Please access delivery terminal for further information.
Name's Sam.
Don't be shy.
Construction complete.
Let's get a move on.
these musical cutscenes, man. I have goosebumps. God damn it.
Shannon Bridges ID.
Don't mind me.
Clear. Weapons detected. All weapons will be locked until the
keep on keeping up. Keep on keeping up.
That weapon is equipped with an advanced targeting mechanism. If you lock on and fire, you'll see exactly what I mean.
Sam.
Thank you, Sam. In reclaiming our past, we've uncovered a number of vital clues. Don't worry, I just got back. We have time. When you met with Mama, You experienced a strong antigen antibody reaction, correct?
There was a BT in the room.
There was, but something else may have been causing it. I've discovered large quantities of chiral matter in Mama as well. Not just the usual kind that collects on our skin or on our suits. It's in all her cells. Cells that are no longer active. The BT you encountered there was special. It was her child, but also her own soul. Somehow, her Ka and Ha failed to separate. They must have remained connected through the umbilical cord. It's the only explanation.
Is that why I didn't get a bruise where she touched me?
Yes. And there's more.
10 seconds to cardiac arrest. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
I modified the log times. Headquarters will have no record of what we say. Look, a message from Dead Man. It came with the umbilical cord.
Sam, I'm sorry. You deserve to know what you were carrying. But I couldn't risk Die Hardman finding out about the case. So I had no choice but to keep it off the books. You've got to keep this between us. We still don't know if the director can be trusted. The umbilical cord was taken from Bridget Strand. I removed it in secret. The cord wasn't attached to a fetus. It was outside her body. She asked me to take care of it. Said it was the key to unlocking the Death Stranding. But she insisted that I never tell the director. The cord shows no sign of decomposition or necrotization. Almost as if it's frozen in time. I thought Hartman might be able to make sense of it. So I had it hidden with your cargo at Mountain Knot City.
Deadman's observations were accurate. It's just like Mama's corpse.
What do you mean?
I mean they share a very unique property. Both contain large amounts of Corellia in their cells. In other words, the president's cord was somehow connected to the beach, and that allowed it to escape the flow of time. I've put together the bones of a theory. It's patchy, but worth sharing, I think. Life on Earth has been rocked by many extinctions, great and small, including the Big Five. And if you examine the Earth's strata, its history, if you will, you'll find Corellium deposits that can be dated to each. What if the manifestation of beaches and other associated phenomena correspond to extinction-level events?
You mean?
Yes. Our Death Stranding could just be the latest of many. The records and research you helped us to recover strongly suggest that we are in the middle of the sixth extinction.
Sixth extinction? Come on.
You know what this is, yes?
A frozen mammoth from 10,000 years ago.
Correct. And this?
The Iceman from 5,300 years ago.
They both had the same umbilical cords.
Bullshit.
Humor me. What if the mammoth and the Iceman weren't frozen?
You're saying time stopped for them just like it did for Mama?
Unfortunately, all these specimens were lost in the Death Stranding, so there's no way to examine the genuine articles. But some fragments of data did survive. With the aid of the chiral network, we may be able to piece together something more concrete using Evo-Devo tech. All right. How's this? A dinosaur from 65.5 million years ago. Umbilical cord? Not decomposed.
Only mammals have umbilical cords.
Mm-mm. No. only mammals have umbilical cords used for childbirth. This is something else. Call it a strand from the other side. I propose that mammalian umbilici are a sort of mimesis of the strand that then evolved over time. We shouldn't assume that everything about a death stranding is detrimental to life. Trilobites, ammonites, dinosaurs, the mammoth, the iceman, all preserved as if frozen in time, all without exception, found with strands, which is to say that all may have been connected to the beach. And this, when viewed in the context of the extinction entity, EE theory, leads me to surmise that organisms with strands are in fact extinction entities. You see, Sam, EEs are connected to the beach via their strands. And it is through this connection that they somehow bring about a death stranding.
So you're saying Bridget was an extinction entity?
It's far too soon to say anything for certain. And since you burned her body, we may never know.
Hicks said Amelie's an EE, that she doesn't have dooms like the rest of us.
Sam, think. Assume that President Strand was an EE. Isn't it possible that her daughter is too? At the very least, Higgs may hope as much now that the president is unavailable.
So he kidnaps her for EE powers or whatever to cause a mass extinction?
Perhaps. Perhaps not. I doubt a single EE is powerful enough to cause a death stranding, assuming Amelie is an EE.
Well, Higgs sure thinks she's got what it takes.
Indeed. And we need to get her back as soon as possible.
1 minute remaining. Please hold on to something secure.
Ah, this one is real. Sam, go west.
How do you want me to handle Die Hard, man?
With your customary reserve. Nothing good will come of him learning of our suspicions. Whatever else is going on, we still need the chiral network.
Right.
Security measures. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Keep on keeping up.
Hello?
It's time, Sam. When you're ready, proceed to the shore of the Tar Belt and begin work on the chiral relay. Once it's ready, use the Cupid to bring it online. The necessary materials are prepped for you. Supplies are limited, so handle them with care. You'll be carrying a lot, too. All things considered, this might be one of your hardest runs to date. Hartman knows more about the site than I do, so he'll take it from here. It's about time for his wake-up call, anyway.
Administering shock. Stand clear.
Right. About that way station. The site we have chosen was an original candidate for the way station we lost to the Tar Belt. Ironically, we suspended construction because we deemed it a little too unstable and not worth the risk. But this time, it's our best shot. So let's hope we weren't right to change horses in midstream. Fortunately for us, the foundation we laid down is still intact. All you have to do is transport the necessary materials to the site and finish the job. I'm afraid it's the only way we can expand the network further west and rescue Amelie. We're counting on you, Sam.
Thank you for your contribution.